Hello everyone, good evening. It's 6 o'clock and it is time for some anatomy topics. Today we are going to talk about Norma Basalis, myself Dr. Rohini. I teach anatomy, some of the topics in microbiology and physiology in the coming months. And anatomy, so far we have covered some of the topics in head and neck region. We have covered a lot of topics in general anatomy. I would urge you to go watch all these topics on YouTube. You can use the code ROHINI to get a discount on the subscriptions. And you also have unlimited access to all these videos. You can like and share all these videos. And please subscribe. So if you want to all watch all the videos without any interruption and without any of the topic getting lost in the pool, please subscribe, please like, and also you can enroll yourself for the plus classes. So plus classes are the classes which will give you in-depth information about NEET, PG, and it will also guide you not just with the subjects. It will also guide you overall. So you will also get a motivation to do well. You'll get to see a lot of tips and quotes that will really motivate you, not just with the subject, with other aspects as well. Whenever you feel low, we also act like your mentors and we boost your energy, and then you will feel like doing even better. So all this can be all this can be achieved or gotten when you subscribe to plus subscription, plus classes. So you have the free classes, that is YouTube classes and special classes. Please watch out for all these classes. My name is Dr. Rohini Vayan, and you can follow me at RoHAQUA, RoHAQUA, and you can watch all the videos that is uploaded by me for an academy. Okay, today we'll start with the topic, that is the Norma Basalis. We have some people who have already messaged. We have Akash. Hello, Akash, Nutan. And we have Abdul. Hi, Abdul. And we have Rishabh. Hi, Rishabh. We have all these students who are regular followers, and please go to my profile, follow me, like the videos that I have uploaded, and you will get a reminder every time there is something new coming up. So you have my classes. One is at 6 o'clock daily, and that will be a topic actually. And then you have my 6 PM class daily will be a YouTube class. This is absolutely free. And then you have another class that is at 7:30. All these are 1 hour classes, 7:30 to 8:30. This is the special class. And then you also have another class which is from 9:30. That is another class. So all these classes are really informative, and then there is and it is all loaded with a lot of MCQs, scenario based questions, and some of the important topics that is needed for cracking NEET PG. So please watch me at this time, 6 p.m., 7:30, and 9:30. And it is on YouTube, and this is if you have a Unacademy Learners app. So if you don't have one Unacademy Learners app, please download, and then you can get a reminder for all these special classes that I'm going to hold. All these special classes are always to have this MCQ based classes. These are, so you will get a lot of information on these things. Okay, so we'll go to the first slide, that is Norma Basalis. So now here you have a view that is from the lower angle, that is, there is a view from the top that is called Norma Verticalis. You have lateralis, you have frontalis, and you also have a view that is from the backside that is called occipitalis. Like that, you also can view the cranial foramina that is from the lower angle that is known as Norma Basalis. Norma Basalis, here you have the alveolar arch and then you have a palate. When you put your finger into your mouth and you can feel that hard surface, that is known as the hard palate. This is called the hard palate. Hard palate is nothing but it is made up of bone. So you have this bone here, maxilla, and the palatine bone here. And you also have at the end of this, there is a crest. To that is an attachment of soft palate, which is made up of muscles. That's why the name soft palate. So you have hard palate and the soft palate. Okay, we have Shubham, we have Yash. Good evening. All right, we have soft palate. We will discuss about the muscles attached to the soft palate and we will discuss about the hard palate and then we'll discuss some foramen as well. So all this we can discuss. Okay, so now we'll move on to the next one. That is, you have this incisor, central incisors. Then you can see that central incisors are these. Right behind that there is a foramen. So this is the incisive foramen. Then you have the hard palate. Both the hard palates are held together by intermaxillary fissure. And you have also have the soft, the other bone that is called the palatine bone. So here you have the interpalatine suture or fissure. So interpalatine. So intermaxillary and interpalatine you have here. And then you have a crest and that is called the crest. This particular thing is called the crest or palatine crest. And this is a very important question. Why it is very important? It's important because what are the attachments on the palatine crest is important. The attachment on the palatine crest is palatine aponeurosis. So very, very important. Palatine aponeurosis. All these things we will study when we study about the soft palate topic. So you can look for this topic, soft palate topic. We are going to do this someday. And we'll discuss about all those five muscles which form the soft palate. There are five muscles which make the soft palate. And we'll discuss about all these five muscles. And then you have this boundary that actually separates the anterior portion or anterior part from the middle part. Now you can see this middle part is mostly made up of the sphenoid bone. You can see a greater wing. You can see the lesser wing of the sphenoid. You can see a small green color bone. Anybody knows what that is? That is called the vomer. That is called the, and it forms a small, joint with the sphenoid. That is a small rostrum part of the sphenoid. And that is known as schindelysis. I've spoken about this many times because it is important. And it has come so many times and it has been repeated. That's the reason I'm also repeating here again and again. We have Achan Khan. Hello, Achan. And then you can see here that there are two crest-like structures. They are called pterygoid plates. There is a medial pterygoid plate and a lateral pterygoid plate. And inside that you have fossa. You can see some fossa. This is called the scaphoid fossa. And there is a hook-like projection that is called the hamillus or hook-like projection. You can see on either side. All right, so this is the vomer and this is the greater wing of the sphenoid. And then you have the lesser wing of the sphenoid. And you also have the crest that is called the palatine crest. And it gives attachment to palatine aponeurosis. Now here at the back, you can see a part of the temporal bone also forms the middle cranial fossa. Now middle cranial fossa, when we call it, is from the inside, that is cranial cavity. So here you can call this as the middle portion of the norma basalis. So it is not a fossa, it is middle part of the norma basalis. So here various structures you can see. Remember in the yesterday's class when we spoke about cranial cavity, I mentioned 2 points. One is the rotundum. Rotundum is not seen in norma basalis. In norma basalis, it is not seen. One more thing, the opening of carotid canal. The carotid canal you can see only in norma basalis. Remember this. Where you cannot see it, you cannot see from the cranial cavity. You cannot see it from the cranial cavity, and only from norma basalis you can see it very clearly. Okay, so that is one important point that you need to remember. So such tricky questions are asked in the NEET PG. So now here you have a spine of the sphenoid. You can see that there is a small projection that is called spine of the sphenoid, and to that there is a ligament that is attached that is called spinomandibular ligament. So there is a mandibular fossa that is for TM joint. And you can see the styloid process. You can see the jugular foramen here. And you can see occipital condyles which form the joint with the atlas here. And then you have a hypoglossal canal that is here. Then you also have a big foramen that is foramen magnum. Yesterday we spoke about all these lines as well. We spoke about external occipital protuberance. There are two things attached. One is ligamentum nuchae and trapezius. Anybody knows what is the action of trapezius and what is its attachment? It takes origin from the external occipital protuberance. Starts from the external occipital protuberance and it covers all the spines, all spines, that is from C cervical vertebrae to the T12. So all the spines, C1 to T12 spines, it will occupy or take attachment on or origin on, and then goes to insertion onto the spine of scapula. So remember, spine. Okay, will you remember this? So it is from spine and spine, that is from the spines of all the spinous process or spines of C1 to T1. And then insertion is on the spine of the scapula. So it is both from spine and spine. So it's easy to remember. But what is its action? The action is shrugging of the shoulder. Shrugging of shoulder. Shrugging of shoulder. It is one of the important muscles of superficial muscles of the back. Superficial muscles of back. It also is an important muscle of climbers. So the ones who want to climb the tree, they want to climb the rock. All these people will have very strong trapezius muscle. You must have observed that it is very strongly developed in case of monkeys and apes. Okay, so monkeys and apes, when we say, you know that they are the ones who like to climb trees and they climb so fast, and they have this muscle trapezius very well developed, and that's why I'm relating it to climbers. And what is the action? Shrugging of the shoulders, lifting up your shoulders in saying as if you're saying, I'm not sure, I don't know action. Okay, that gesture is because of the action of trapezius. Okay, next one. All right. Here, I just want to mention it to you that you need an Academy Learners app. You want to watch my classes, that is special classes. This is exclusively for those who have this app. It is not for everyone. So please download. We download so many things. Why not download something that is related to education? When you are, your target is to crack NEET PG, I think you should download whatever is available to motivate you and reaching your goal. So please download an Academy Learners app and you can look for NEET PG section where you can go for the list of educators. You can watch all my videos by looking for this Rohini. You can look for this name and then you can follow. You can subscribe. And before you leave, you please like. Okay, like, your likes will count and then it will motivate us to do even more better. So your likes are most welcome. So please like and give me a thumbs up whenever you have logged in and that will motivate us. And if you have any particular topic in mind that you want to discuss, you can always message and request. And I'll keep that in mind and include in my classes because we don't know exactly from your point of, individually what exactly you're looking for. So each person will have a different requirement according to me. So what is important to you or what is a tough subject for you may not be a tougher one for the other person. So it's always important that you speak out, you ask what you want, you subscribe and you have a list of topics that you can select from. You can also customize what you want to learn. All this you can do when you do the plus subscription. And here to get a glimpse of what you can get, you can always message me and I'll give you a demo of what you can expect. All right. Yes, Yash, it is the climber's muscle. Yeah, you have been answering all my MCQs also really well. And I'm really happy for you. And I'm sure you'll back some good seed. This is the one kind of a motivational quote from my side. You'll definitely get something good because I have been watching your answers. Your answers are most of the time correct. So it is the really nice thing. And you're very interactive as well. And yes, Rishabh, that is how you subscribe. Okay, anterior part of the norma basalis, you have alveolar arch, which we saw. We saw the heart palate, incisive fossa, greater palatine, lesser palatine, posterior nasal. So the heart palate is something that is associated with the cleft lip, cleft palate. So this is one of the anomaly we can list under development of hard palate. Okay, that is from primary and secondary. So hard palate develops from primary and the secondary palate. And most of the time during the development, you know that there is development of face, which is formed by five processes, right? The face develops by five processes. You have this is the face. If this is your nose and there are five processes which give rise to, there is this frontal process, there is maxillary process, there is mandibular process. So how many are over? Three. Then there is a medial nasal process and there is a lateral nasal. Medial nasal process is this one which gives rise to the, and then there is this philtrum, that is a gap between your nose and the mouth. So this is given by the medial nasal process. It again joins with the lateral nasal process, which forms the ala of the nose, the part which flares up. So medial nasal, lateral nasal process. So this is maxillary. So lateral nasal process and maxillary process, they have to fuse. So by fusion of all these processes and also by the fusion of the two sides of frontal process, two sides of maxillary and mandibular process, we get a symmetric face. Okay, so there are so many things that happen during this. There, it could be because of vitamin A, increase in vitamin A, or it could be because of excessive cigarette smoking. That could also be one of the reason. All these things, or it could be to do with the genes. Okay, it is hereditary. So all these things also can influence the anomalies in the facial head and neck formation. All right, next one. Norma basalis. Now here, anterior part, if you see, you have this alveolar arch, you have the alveolar process, you have the palatine process of the maxilla. This is the palatine process, this one. Then you have the horizontal. So just to tell you some more about this Unacademy, you have this limited time offer where you can do the subscription to NEET PG Iconic subscription. You have about, earlier it was about 92,000. Now the rate has come down. They have reduced it drastically to about 58. It is for 36 months. And you can also go for the lease and try it out. That is 12-month subscription for just 40. And you can use this code, that is ICON10, for getting this limited time offer. So please try all this on. And before that, you can try our classes, watch our classes, and get customers to all these classes, and start liking the classes by downloading the learners app of Unacademy. All right, let's move on to the heart palate. Heart palate, you have all these structures. You have the sutures, that is intermaxillary, interpalatine suture, and this also, there is palatomaxillary. This is palatomaxillary suture. This is the dome-shaped arch, and you can see that there are pits in all directions for palatine glands. You have palatine glands. This is one question that has been asked before. So what are those pits for? Can you see the small pits here? What are all these for? They're all for palatine glands. Okay, next one. You have this maxilla. Okay, just like fan blades, it is in three different directions. You have the zygomatic process, you have the frontal process, and you have the one which is projecting downwards, that is alveolar process, which is projecting downwards. So how many processes? Three processes, just like the blades of the fan in three different directions. Okay. Incisive fossa, it is a fossa that is situated deeply. So much of osteology and what is the need of so much osteology, but no, everything is important, because there was one question where they had asked greater and lesser palatine foramen belong to which bone. So you have to remember, the name itself tells you, but still some people forget and they say that it is maxilla, thinking that hard palate is made of maxilla. So they will pick the maxilla as the answer. But the answer is palatine bone. So this is palatine bone. So greater and lesser palatine foramina belong to the palatine bone. So here you have a conchae from the nasal cavity, and you can also see the vomer. You have all these other structures that are presented in the middle cranial fossa that belong to the sphenoid bone. Okay, so now here you can see what are the parts. You can see you have a palatine crest, which I mentioned it to you. This is the boundary of the anterior cranial fossa. This is where your soft palate muscles are attached, especially the musculus jugulae. muscular fibula is attached to this particular portion. Next one, okay. Anterior part of the norma basalis. Again, the same things are mentioned here. I'll move on to the middle part of the norma basalis. Now here you can see this is the vomer and there is a tubercle. Can you see here? There is a tubercle and this particular portion is called basiocciput. And how is this basiocciput formed? It is half of sphenoid and half of occipital bone. So this half is made of sphenoid, the other half is of the occipital bone. So this is called basiocciput and there is a pharyngeal tubercle to which the constrictor muscles of pharynx. This is the constrictor muscles of pharynx takes the attachment. So this is very, very important. Next we have pterygoid process of the sphenoid bone. There is a medial pterygoid and there is a lateral pterygoid. And then you can also see the fossa that is called the scaphoid fossa. And then you can also see on the medial pterygoid plate, you can see the hamulus. So now middle portion, you have this small portion that is because of the vomer. And that vomer actually divides this nasal cavity into right and left openings. And then there is a broad bar of bone that is formed by the fusion of this posterior part of the body of the sphenoid. And you can see that this is sphenoid and this is of the occipital bone. So this is one question that is asked, basiocciput. Basiocciput is formed by which two bones? You should remember the sphenoid and the occipital bone. So this is one question to remember. So whenever such things are told and discussed, it is always better to just write it down. So that will help you remember whenever you write something, it will stay in your mind. And when you are able to recall, you'll remember that you wrote about it and you made it very important, sound very important to yourself because you wrote it once. So you'll retain the information well when you write it once. Okay, so this is the section where you can see, what section is this? You can see there is a mid sagittal section where you can see the septum. So this is the hard palate where you can see the maxilla, you can see the palatine bone, part of the vomer bone, and then that forms the nasal septum. You can see the perpendicular plate of ethmoid bone. So there is one more question. The olfactory nerves, they pierce which bone? See, now you can see that it pierce the bone. They pierce which bone? They pierce the ethmoid bone and that opens into a bulb that is called olfactory bulb and that lies in the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone. Okay. And there is a sinus here that is frontal sinus. And there is a small piece of nasal and there is a small piece of frontal as well extending here. And there is a sphenoid air sinus also. So this is one air sinus. This is another air sinus that you can see in this section. All right, next one. So here there are so many structures. You can see there is this membranous lamina of cartilaginous part of pharyngotympanic tube. You can see here in the small portion that is the foramen spinosum. that is foramen spinosum. Okay, so that is one extra thing that you can notice here. This is the portion which forms the middle part. So this is middle part. But in the middle part, we were talking about this portion. Now we will move to this portion, the sides. Now the sides has got this butterfly shaped, bone. And it has this optic canal. This is one question that is asked most of the time. EPG, what is that question? Where is optic canal present? In which bone it is present? Now you can see part of the sphenoid. You can see the lesser wing. Right, you can see the greater wing and you can see the body. Now, this optic canal belongs to which one? Does it belong to lesser wing, body or the greater wing? It belongs to the body. So that is what you are supposed to write. It belongs to the body of the sphenoid bone. In this, you can also see rotundum, ovale and spinosum, ROS. And you can see medial and lateral pterygoid plates. The pterygoid plates give attachment to pterygoid muscles. Which one? The lateral plate gives attachment to the pterygoid muscles. Which are they? That is medial pterygoid and lateral pterygoid. So both of them, they take origin from the lateral pterygoid plate. That is medial part of lateral pterygoid plate and lateral part of lateral pterygoid plate. So you remember, this is another question that is important for NEET. Okay, so now you have medial pterygoid, lateral pterygoid, two muscles. Both of them take origin from the lateral pterygoid plate only, not from the medial pterygoid plate. Okay, next one. Okay, so you have grooves also that you can see here. You can see the foramen rotundum, spinosum, then you can see socket for the TM joint. You can see the carotid canal, and then you can see external auditory canal you can see. And then you can see the styloid, jugular, mastoid process, styloid process. All these are present in the lateral part of the middle portion of norma basalis. Okay, now here, this is the lateral most part where you can see the temporal bone. You can see the parts of the temporal bone. It has the mastoid process, it has the squamous part, and it has got this tympanic part, that is 3. Then it has the zygomatic part, 4, and it has styloid part, 5. So how many parts are present? 5 parts for the temporal bone. There are 5 parts of the temporal bone. Okay, so now we have. Now who is this? Be yourself. You have to put your name so that I can mention your name. I'm wondering, you're always there in my classes. Thanks for attending all the classes, but I don't know your name. I wish I would know your name. Okay. All right. We have zygomatic. Then this is the mandibular fossa. You can see the external acoustic meatus, which is a bony structure, but it will be cartilaginous until the age of 2 years. It is cartilaginous structure. All right. You have mastoid foramen and there is stylomastoid foramen. That is different. This is different. This is different. What passes through this? Emissary. What passes through this? Facial. And what passes through this? 9th, 10th and 11th cranial nerves. What passes through this? Internal carotid artery. What about styloid process? 2, ligaments, 3, muscles. And zygomatic process, what is the attachment? Setup. Okay, so that is something you must remember. Next, you have a mandibular fossa, that is for TM joint. mastoid process, you have three muscles. Are there any ligaments? No ligaments. No ligaments, only muscles. Okay, next one, coming to this foramen that you can see in the posterior part of the norma basalis, you can see a very big foramen. Can you see this? This is a very big foramen that is called foramen magnum. Then you have this external occipital protuberance here. You have external occipital crest. This is the crest and this is the protuberance. And you also have superior nuchal line passing through the external occipital. This is very important. These two are the same line. This was a question for PG one time. That is the line that extends from the external occipital protuberance is superior nuchal line. And what is the attachment on that? There are two things. One is the sternocleidomastoid and trapezius. And both of them are supplied by 11th cranial nerve. What is that? Spinal accessory nerve. One time I am planning to, you know, take up all the spinal nerves, that is starting from the first cranial nerve up to the 12th cranial nerve. All the cranial nerves one by one. First, what is its name? The course, then what is the exit and what all it supplies. And same thing I'm going to do with all the cranial nerves. And then if there is an injury, what is the loss? What are the abnormalities that is caused, that happens? So all this we can discuss when we take up one cranial nerve at a time. And each day we will discuss one cranial nerve in detail. So that will almost cover your half of your neuroanatomy. So half of your neuroanatomy is done just by covering the cranial nerves. You won't believe this, but that is the truth. Okay, next one, lateral portion. So now we were talking about the posterior aspect of the norma basalis. You can see the condylar parts. Can you see this condylar part? This is the condylar part, which is bean-shaped structure. It forms atlanto-occipital joint. Then you have squamous part. This is the squamous part. Then you have jugular foramen here. That is a gap. That is jugular foramen that you can see here. And then you have styloid process and the mastoid process. All this you can see in the lateral aspect. What attaches to these structures? I have mentioned in the previous slide. Next one. Okay, so now here, what happens to these occipital condyles? Now you can see this individual bone, that is occipital bone, and this is the internal occipital protuberance where there is this confluence of sinuses. Which sinuses come? The straight sinus, the transverse sinus, this is straight sinus, transverse sinus, and then you also have the sigmoid sinus, and then there is this occipital sinus. So all these, they meet in this point that is called confluence of sinuses. So that is one thing that you can remember. And then here you have occipital condyles on the outside. These are occipital condyles, and they are the ones which form a joint with atlas to form atlanto-occipital. You can do this nod as you're saying yes. This nod you can do with this joint. So what is the action that you can do? You can do flexion and extension. It's very, very important. It is one question that was asked in G. So, atlanto-occipital joint gives you what kind of action? So you would be expecting that, you know, as if you're nodding yes. To nod as, what is the movement that is done? Is flexion and extension. There is the hyperextension also that can break the, you know, the vertebral bodies. That is different. That is actually a whiplash fracture of the vertebrae. So that is completely different. And we are talking about just simple flexion and extension. Okay, that happens in atlanto-occipital joint. Next, you have hypoglossal, that is for the 12th cranial nerve, that is present right in front of this. You can see it better from the other side, that is where it is, the hypoglossal. This is condylar canal. The hypoglossal canal is inside, which you are not able to see in this particular. So it is not shown, and it is on the inner side. It will be here. Okay, this is where it is. That is hypoglossal canal. Okay, next one, jugular. You already know what is jugular, and you know jugular foramen, 9th, 10th, and 11th cranial nerves. But also, there are two more things. One is inferior petrosal sinus and the sigmoid sinus. Sigmoid sinus is a continuation of transverse sinus. And then sigmoid sinus enters the jugular foramen. It enters the jugular foramen. So you must remember, transverse sinus is this one. It continues down as the sigmoid sinus, and then sigmoid sinus would enter the jugular foramen. So that is something you must remember. Sigmoid sinus enters the jugular foramen. The next one. Attachments on the exterior of the skull. Exterior of the skull, you can see that there is a posterior border of hard palate, aponeurosis is there, then spine is there for that musculus muscle is attached. I mentioned it to you. There are five muscles. Out of that, one of them is musculus. So all the muscles are held to musculus. Next, we will talk about more on this in my upcoming classes on soft palate. Palatine crest will give attachment to tensor veli palatini muscle. Tensor veli palatini muscle. This is one muscle. Next, you have pharyngeal tubercle, that is superior constrictor muscle of pharynx. So these are the attachments. This is a very important slide. Very, very important slide. Because you know what are the attachments. You have palatine aponeurosis, musculus. This is tensor veli palatini muscle. What are the other muscles you have? Levator veli, palatini, musculus, then palatoglossus, palatopharynx. So let's list out all those muscles since we are talking so much about soft palate. One, two, three, four, five. There are five different muscles. So these are the muscles which attach. They form a common, you know, tendon that is on the musculus. So they have an insertion on the musculus, and that's how the soft palate functions. We will discuss in detail about all these things in my upcoming classes. You can subscribe to my classes that is coming up next month. They are the classes, they are called the plus classes. So plus classes, you will get to see lot of study material you will get to read, and then you will have MCQs from the material that I have shared, and all the points will be discussed. Any, you know, points, any questions that is raised, it will be discussed there. And you can also post questions for me, and then you can also form my Telegram. You please see this video. There is a drop down. You can subscribe. You can see the drop down next to the title. Next to the title, you can see the drop down. Please use the drop down to get a list of links that you can go to. You can go to the subscriptions. You can go to the feedback. You can give your feedback, how you like the class, all that you can, what you expect more from the classes. You can give your feedback. And you can also join this Telegram group where we share the PPT slides, and you get to see a lot of activity going on there. Then all the upcoming classes will be listed there. All that you can see, and when you join this Telegram group. So please do join. Next, we have incisive foramen. Incisive foramen is this one. What are the structures? Greater palatine, nasopalatine. And then you have greater palatine foramen, that is greater palatine vessels. You have behind that a small foramen, that is lesser palatine. That is this one, greater is this one. This is the incisive. You have the palatine vessels. Then you have foramen ovale, that is this one. You can see here. You have four things, M, A, L, mandibular axis, the meningeal artery, lesser petrosal, and emissary vein. So these are some of the structures that pass through these foramen. Norma basalis is one important thing. If you understand this, it could be sounding little basic, but if you know this well, then you can answer a whole lot of questions. Whole lot of questions can be answered just by knowing the attachments of the muscles and structures passing through the foramen. You have this portion where you can see the cribriform plate. So now this is what you can see in the, this is what you can see from the interior, that is interior of cranium. See, whatever you saw in the norma basalis, the same thing you can see. That is in the middle cranial fossa, you can see. Middle cranial fossa, you can see the same thing. In the posterior cranial fossa, you can see the same thing. But not in the anterior. Anterior cranial fossa is lifted little high. It is at an elevation. That is because of the face structures in the face. You have orbit. So orbit forms the roof of the orbit is formed by this portion, that is orbital plate of the frontal bone. So you can see that orbital plate of the frontal bone forms roof of the orbit. So below that will be the orbit, and this portion is orbital plate. Okay, so now that portion is not same as the norma basalis. It looks different because the structures are different. Middle one will be same, posterior will be same. So you can see the similar things on the other side also, except for one thing, that is foramen rotundum, which you cannot see from the norma basalis. So quickly, let's see what are the structures passing through. You have optic canal, optic nerve, cribriform plate, olfactory, superior orbital fissure. All these things supply the eyeball. Oculomotor, trochlear, ophthalmic, and abducens. All these supply the eyeball. Rotundum, maxillary, mandibular division, then of the trigeminal. So there is one division going here of trigeminal, one division in this foramen, another division in this. Of which one? Trigeminal. Next you have internal acoustic meatus. That has two structures, seventh and eighth. Next you have, if there is a tumor present in this region, it could affect, if there is a tumor present in this region, it could affect even the facial nerve. Okay, not just the vestibulocochlea, it could also affect the facial nerve. Next, jugular foramen, 9th, 10th and 11th. See, it is going in order. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have 6, then we have 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. It is in order. It is given in order. You have to remember it in order. Okay, next one. You have hypoglossal, that is from the hypoglossal canal here. You can see the jugular here. You can see the internal acoustic is here. You can see this ovale is here. This one is spinosum for middle meningeal artery. Next, you have the rotundum. This is rotundum. You have the optic canal. This is the fissure. This is the okay, we'll move to the next one. We are okay, what is the structure passing through the foramen lacerum? Because this is one actually filled with fibrous tissue. Is it filled with fibrous tissue when in dead or in living people? Okay. Shivank wants to say something. What is that? What is your question? Okay, I'm so sorry, Shivank. I didn't see your messages. I was so busy with the, you know, looking at the screen. Okay, what is your question? I'm in BDS. Can I attend? What is the schedule for classes? Yes, you can definitely attend whenever we have your, you know that, you very well know that it is the head and neck region what you have to study. So all my head and neck, classes, whenever I take, by just by looking at the topic, you will know that it is from the head and neck. So all that you can attend. I would be covering almost all, but not 100%, because these are all free classes. You have to get a plus subscription if you want in detail classes. Okay. So that is one thing, Shivank. And you can definitely go for all these YouTube free classes. You can definitely log into my special classes by having a Unacademy Learners app. Go to Unacademy, in the Play Store, download the app, and then look for the educator, Rohini YN, and then you follow me, subscribe, then automatically you will get a reminder whenever there is my class. Okay, I hope that answers my question. I'm sorry, not respond. Yes, that is my question. Yes. All right. Yes, he says thanks. All right. So now next one. Pterygotympanic fissure, chorda tympani nerve, and anterior tympanic artery. So that is pterygoid, between the pterygoid and the tympanic. Where is it? Pterygoid is the pterygoid process. Okay, pterygoid process. So that is one thing, and tympanic fissure. So between that, you have the chorda tympani nerve. What is this chorda tympani nerve? This is the branch from the facial. And what do you think is the function of chorda tympani? It is a special sensory nerve. Special sensory to tongue. You know that the anterior two-thirds of the tongue is the only one which has got all these papillae. You have the papillae in the anterior two-thirds of the tongue, and only that can take all this sensation of sweet, sour, salt, and bitter. So that is done by chorda tympani. Okay, that is what carries your special taste. Then who will tell you what is hot or cold, whether what you are eating food is hot or cold? That is lingual. Lingual tells you hot and cold. Good. Food is hot, food is cold. So what is this called? General sensory. General sensory is by lingual. Special sensory is by chorda tympani. And these are for anterior two-third only. Because that is the place you have the papillae. Okay, next one, the last one, foramen magnum. So foramen magnum is, we have a posterior part, and then we have subarachnoid part, and the narrowest anterior part. So it is from front to back. So now you can see this is the anterior most, this is the subarachnoid and posterior. So these are the structures. You can see this medulla oblongata, the three meninges, lower part of the medulla oblongata, that is brain stem, the three meninges, dura, arachnoid and pia mater. Then you have spinal accessory nerves, Then you have which part of vertebral artery? Third part of vertebral artery. Okay. Then you have sympathetic plexus that is present around the vertebral artery. Then you have posterior spinal arteries. How many of them? Two of them. Then how many anterior? There is only one of them. This is very, very important for your need. How many anterior? How many posterior? There are two posterior. There is only one anterior. Then you have apical ligament of Dens, that is in the axis vertebra. The vertebra is C2. And it has this ligament. It's called apical ligament. Then you have cruciate ligaments, that is membrana pectoria. So that is again, all these are passing through the anterior part. This is passing through posterior, and then through the space you have all these structures. Okay. So this is how you remember. Next one, this picture shows you the anterior part, the middle portion and the posterior portion, okay, which has got this medulla oblongata and the tonsils of the cerebellum. So this is how you can see the different, I told you it is little difficult to see the hypoglossal. So they also mentioned the same thing. Hypoglossal is little difficult, but condylar are, this is condylar, this is hypoglossal. So that's why there is a probe that has passed through it. This is the one. And here you can also see the sigmoid sinus. Okay. The sigmoid sinus. This is a transverse. This is sigmoid. How it enters the jugular. So in this direction it is going. Next one. There are so many age-related changes when it comes to the skull. You have thinner, lighter skull, becomes reduced in size, the bones, decrease in vertical height of the face, that also decreases. Angle of the mandible also becomes more and more obtuse as you age. Remember, so it is more obtuse. And with the age, it becomes more obvious. So that's the end of all the slides that we have. And thanks for watching. And I would request all of you to log in again at 7:30 p.m. We are going to discuss brachial plexus. Okay, this is a class. And then again, we are going to have MCQs. It's going to be a lot of interactive MCQs. And again, it's on the same topic, brachial plexus and a lot of nerves. Then upper limb, basically upper limb is what I'm going to cover today. So it's one important thing which has got a lot of weightage in MCQs. So you have to know brachial plexus to understand the upper limb muscles and their supply, and all the clinical aspects you want to understand, you must watch this class at 7:30 and at 9:30. This is today.